Just doesn't get much better than this. It's whispering a prayer relationship philosophy via a little scenario that takes place on Friday afternoon about 5 o'clock. In this particular case, the husband has been out of town all week and now is walking to the front porch, heavily laden and with luggage and a bulging briefcase. He doesn't want to sit everything down to ring the bell or to get out his keys, so he kicks the door to get his wife's attention. He doesn't just kick the door lightly, he kicks it in a frustrating and angered, and in the process damages the door. Not very good, if you ask me. His wife, upon hearing the commotion, rushes to the door, opens it, and is startled to see her husband standing there. Without getting down, his belongings, he delivers this oration. "I'm late because I've been in a meeting, and I'm really glad I was there. I learned some things that really bug me. I learned, for example, that there are a number of rights around this house that I have not been getting, and as a matter of fact, I've had a list of those rights. The first thing you and I are going to do is to sit down and talk, because I'm telling you right now, there are going to be some changes around here." When he finishes, the wife responds, "Well, Buster, I didn't go to a meeting. I didn't need to, and I haven't written a list. I didn't need to do that either. It is burned indelibly into my mind. There are some rights around here that I haven't been getting. So you come on in, and I will talk about it. Because I agree with you that there are going to be some changes made, and you're not going to like the most of them. Most of them." Can't you just imagine the delightful, loving, and romantic, exhilarating weekend that followed this encounter? Don't you just know that on a Monday morning, husband and wife left home charged up with the renewed excitement and determination to go out and change the world, to make it a better place to live? So, take two. Now, change the scenario slightly. On the same front porch, on the same Friday afternoon, the same husband walks to the porch, heavily laden with his luggage and bulging briefcase. He doesn't want to set down his things to ring the bell or want to use his keys. So he urgently taps the door with his foot. His wife opens the door, and as she does, he looks at her and begins his oration. "Sweetheart, I apologize for being late. I'm delighted to be here now. I'm late because I went to perhaps the most important meeting of our lives. In this meeting, I learned some things that really bother me. I've learned, for example, that in all probability, I've not been meeting the needs that you have as my wife. Before I even unpack, I would like for us to sit down and talk. I would like for you to tell me what I can do to become the kind of husband that you deserve to have and that you thought you were getting when we married." In response, his example, your chances of being a rocket scientist are slim if you flunked the fifth grade math twice. So spending several years in college taking every course you need to be a rocket scientist, but avoiding the math classes until the last semester is the same as planning to fail. Unrealistic expectations are the seedbed of depression. If you've gained 20 pounds over the last 3 years, believing that you can lose all 20 pounds in 3 or 4 weeks is setting yourself up for failure. That goal just isn't realistic.
Good.
very strong healthy, I'm of the very strong opinion, not based on scientific research, but years of observation, that these people also have more friends, more peace of mind, more security, and more people, more hope in the future. These factors contribute to a longer and more rewarding life. I've never met the depressed individual who had specific long-range goals and a plan of action to reach them. Specific.